Son the judges are Chris Flores, Gustavo Valenzuela, and Chris Wilson. The referee, Wes Melton. And now, ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, from Parker, Arizona, veremos quién es el más macho. Introducing the blue corner, presentando la esquina azul, vestido de dorado con vivos rojos. He steps in wearing gold trimmed in red. He weighed in officially at 136 pounds, detuvo la báscula, a un peso oficial de 136 libras. Con 16 victorias profesionales, 6 derrotas, un empate, y 3 de sus victorias por la vía del knockout, he enters the ring with 16 professional victories against 6 losses, 1 bout even, and 3 of his victories coming by way of knockout. Fighting out of Denver, Colorado, Manny Mano. His opponent across the ring in the red corner. Su contrario en la esquina roja. Vestido de plateado con color naranja. He steps in wearing silver trimmed in orange. He weighed in at an identical 136 pounds. Detuvo la báscula a un peso idéntico de 136 libras. He enters the ring, an undefeated fighter with 22 victories. One bout even and 12 of his victories coming by way of knockout. Invicto hasta el momento a nivel profesional con 22 victorias. Un empate y 12 de sus victorias por la vía del knockout. Representing Lobogon, the Philippines, Mercito No Mercy Pesta.
Chief second. 1 second, over. Okay, gentlemen. Went over the rules in the dressing room. Check these trunks. These are good. From here, it's going to be low. Check these trunks. These are good. I'm going to call them low from here. I want you to have a good, clean fight. Protect yourself at all times. And obey my commands. Let's touch them up and bang at the bell.
And it looks as though Manny Perez's nose is marked up already.
Yep. But it got busted up. And that second fight is against Brandon Rios. He's had some tough sparring sessions, talked about how hard he's been working for this fight. Said he couldn't be more prepared. He's had 9 weeks to get ready for Hesta. Will it be enough? We'll have to see. Hesta, you know, he talked about at the top of the telecast about trying to live up, and he's not really trying to, but you know, everything's compared to Pacquiao and Donaire. There's some things I see, Rich, that he does very well is that he can throw from all angles. He's got a very big repertoire of punches that can hurt you, uppercuts, hooks, body punches, right there going downstairs.
Right. Well, he's left-handed to start with, so that's the first similarity to Manny. And he will give you angles and some different looks, but not the crazy angles that Pacquiao gives you. I mean, we've actually seen Pacquiao on a number of occasions, and it really, all kidding aside, he winds up behind his opponents, you know. So, I haven't seen that yet with Hesta. And Hesta trying to give some different looks here to Perez. He's going to be ready, I think, for just about anything tonight.
Yeah, he's in the white trunks with the, I guess it's kind of an orange trim, Hesta is, and Perez digging in the body, which we figured he was going inside right there. He'll be right in front of him. Hesta's giving that smile, which tells maybe he did get to his body a little bit there.
Well, that was my first key to victory for Perez tonight, was to get to the body, and I think that's what he has in mind, and I think that's what he's going to try to do. He's a come-forward fighter. Hesta, for his part, can either come forward or go backwards or go side to side. He's the more versatile of the two. But Perez has got to get in there and mix it up. He's going to be better off, he feels, if he has an opportunity to exchange with Hesta.
You can tell that Perez, in the gold trunks with the red trim, he came here tonight knowing what was on the line for him and what he's trying to accomplish. He came out firing right here. You see some of it. He's intense right here in the first round. We're scheduled for 10. This is lightweight action from Parker, Arizona. Hesta responding now.
But it is ironic that as we watch and make these comparisons to Pacquiao, that Hesta tonight is fighting a guy named Manny.
Maybe it was sort of a lead left there. I think it's been a big plus for Hesta to sign with the top rank organization. He gets a lot of support behind him.
Perez right in there as we expected, having a good first round with Hesta. Hesta's a patient fighter.
That's what you were talking about. That's one thing you've been very impressed with, the fact that he doesn't lose his cool. He's going to can chop you down if he can.
Right. And as you can see, the pace he sets is not that frenetic Pacquiao type of pace.
Nice right hand it got in there from Hester.
It's much more measured pace that Hester fights. And, you know, watching Manny can make you nervous just watching him. The ring gets so frenetic and frenzied.
Well, we saw the development of Manny over the years, and finally when he got to Freddie and became a more complete fighter, and his defense was somewhat lacking. Hester's talking about his defense somewhat lacking. I don't think Manny really ever cared about the defense, to tell you the truth. But it pays off as you move up in your career and move up in weight. Closing out round number one, lightweight division here from Parker, Arizona. We're back in Arizona, round number two, lightweight division. Left side of your screen, Mercito No Mercy Hesta from the Philippines taking on Manny Perez from Denver right here. Round number two scheduled for 10.
I thought Perez had a pretty good first round. I gave him that first round based on aggression in that first round. He got a few shots in there. And I think Hesta looks like he's getting down to business a little bit more now here in round number two. But Perez came out ready to fight. As you said, he knows what this fight means to him now. It's kind of everything for him.
Well, his corner was convinced over there. Steve Mestis, his trainer, was very pleased with his first round from Perez.
Perez lives in Denver, trains at altitude. Used to be a stable mate with the highly regarded comer Mike Alvarado. No longer. Meantime, Hesta is now living and training in San Diego. He used to be up at in Los Angeles and also used to train at the Wild Card, but now he's down in San Diego.
He's got an interesting situation as they're getting into it now. Perez is doing what he likes to do, getting in there and banging, potentially picking up. It's a situation that Hesta was considered one of the best ever young Muay Thai kickboxers in the Philippines. So he brings his trainer over, longtime trainer over, to work with him in San Diego. Then he's got Vince Parra. Then he's got a little input from Wild Card. And so he's comfortable in San Diego there. There's a lot of Filipinos there, good Filipino barbecue. So he's fine. He keeps in touch.
That's the important thing.
He keeps in touch with his family 7,000 miles away through that thing called Skype, where you can actually see the folks and talk to them.
So I love that Skype.
Nice little ripped uppercut that barely missed the mark. Tell you what, Rich, Perez is doing a good job.
I'm not surprised. I'm expecting him to fight this way all night. He's getting close. When he gets close, he unloads his flurry and gets right out of there. Hesta, I think, looks to me like he's still trying to figure out Perez, still studying him in there, and hasn't quite developed a game plan yet.
Hesta got caught on a little counter right there. It wasn't a real hard punch, but he did get caught on a counter. It's kind of surprising. Hesta told us that Perez is going to be right in front of him. Because Perez admits it too. That's where he has to be. Try to work the body, work inside. You see Hesta looking in. Perez looking straight at the sternum, right at the chest. Not looking at the eyes or the head. He's looking right at the chest because he wants to go to that body. Body doesn't move.
Bring him up.
Concentrate right there. Center of that body. That's a veteran.
Well, I think so far, that was a good counter right there, though, by Hesta. But
banging away at the body, final seconds of round number two. Hesta's got his work cut out for him tonight, Rich Barada, I'm telling you.
Because Perez is in there hustling. Fight off to an interesting start. There you see a good ripping right hand. Well, actually, both fighters threw it once, but it was Perez, I thought, who out-hustled him again. I've given Perez both of the first two rounds.
As we said, he got a little skip when he was going to the corner. Perez just kind of danced over the corner like, hey, I'm doing pretty good. And his corner confirmed and said, look, you got caught a couple of times. Don't let that happen again. Hester's pace is a little slow to me, Rich. I know you've seen him many, many times. I've seen him a couple of times. But he's just kind of befuddled right now. And Perez is prepared. I got to give all the credit Perez's first two rounds to him. He's prepared for this fight.
Yeah.
Almost walked into one right there, though.
Hesta still seems to me to be figuring out his opponent. Coming inside, just picking up his movement a little, picking up his punch output a little bit as Hesta, and that's what he's got to do. Perez is the one showing some movement now. A little bit of an adjustment by Manny.
Perez got caught there. I don't know if he wants to do too much bouncing up and down against this guy. Lead left from Hesta.
No shoulders, no shoulders.
Perez admits that fighting left-handers is a bit of an issue. He said he's more comfortable with them now. He started at the beginning of camp, and he said it's a little different, but he had a full camp, a grueling, dedicated camp, he said. So we're going to see the best Manny Perez here tonight that he has to offer. Good test for Hesta.
Once again, Manny Perez is in the gold trunks. Hesta's in the white trunks. Hesta giving a little head fake, a little showboat type thing there, saying, come after me. Wants him to come in. I don't know what that's all about, because Perez is just good enough to hurt you if you get careless.
Well, he might have been a little embarrassed there, so Hesta thought he was going to give it back to him, give him the business a little, I guess you could say.
Well, this could get interesting. Like I said, this argument developing into a very, very interesting workout for Hesta, to say the least. If not, he could be in trouble.
Those punches were all blocked. Good defense there by Hesta.
Hesta's been fighting one form or another since he was 7 years old. He's born to this. And you have to think that the kickboxing background helps you with have footwork. He's got those big, strong legs like Manny Pacquiao has, the big, thick trunks that gives him such a solid base in there.
Sure, and now he's unloading some punches. He's getting good leverage into the
good punches. Rib shot right there.
Yeah, very nicely done.
That hurt Perez.
Hesta's doing better, much better this round.
He just got caught right there. But, you know, the harder punches are coming from Hesta. But he got Perez with a good rib shot. There's a good right hand using the speed. Holding his hands down low now is Hesta. Almost inviting Perez to come in. I think his confidence level just picked up here in round two. And Perez goes pouring in. Now Hesta's giving him the business. He's trying to goad Perez. Very interesting turn of events.
Well, the fight's getting, as they say, curiouser and curiouser. Yep. As that Perez landed that to flurry of punches, and then the showboating of Hesta, who I still think Hesta had his best round of the fight in that round.
Round number four scheduled for 10 lightweight division. Perez's corner is very pleased with what they've seen. And that's usually either a smile or some kind of reaction when you get caught a little bit. I think Perez is doing as good as he can do.
And they warned Hesta not to wait too long on Perez to try to get off first. Good combination there from Mercito.
Well, one thing you can say is Hesta by now has felt whatever type of power Perez is bringing to him, and I would be safe to say he doesn't respect it very much.
Well, Perez is not a big power puncher. The few stoppages as he has are not a result really of great power. He's just a banger, you know? I mean, he's a grinder in there. He makes it tough on opponents, and he hopes to grind you down. And I'll tell you, it's no easy task to grind him down. Not when you go the distance with the likes of Brandon Rios and Diego Magdaleno.
Exactly right. Came up short in those. But he's one of those fighters that's just almost there.
Right.
And if he can draw that experience, he's fought better competition. You could say that for sure than Hesta. It's just a matter of talent. And he's trying to make magic happen tonight. Nice combination right there. And Hesta took it and didn't budge. Matter of fact, Hesta didn't respond at all. It's a very strange fight.
Yeah, I think Hesta needs to start getting off first.
Yep.
I mean, he's
right. There you go. As you said it, it came to left right there, and Perez got hurt by that.
Yeah, Perez is stealing it. He's actually almost running away at this point. He felt that one big time.
You're very prescient that way, aren't you, Murata? He needs to do, oh, they just did it. And it's got Perez's attention now. We're in the fourth round, 1 minute left. Yeah, that lead right was wicked. It took Perez completely out of whatever rhythm he was trying to work up to. Now, Perez will take a lot of punishment. And Hesta's certainly got a lot of pop to deliver. Now, Perez trying to clear the cobwebs now and work back downstairs, back upstairs. But like I'm saying, the difference so far to me, even though Rich Murata gave Hesta, didn't get the first two rounds this fight. It's just a matter of how much Hesta responds to whatever Perez is bringing, and it's not intimidating. Maybe that's why he's being so patient, Rich.
Pretty good right there, though, by Perez. You know, Hesta had the momentum going in this round, and he's kind of held back a little bit.
Yeah, just saying this corner was complaining about, you know, holding back too much. Oh, good punches here from both sides. 10 seconds left, round number four. Entertaining lightweight fight from Arizona so far on Top Rank Live as they go to the fifth.
Best moment of the fight for Recito Hesta in that last round, that long left hand. It kind of put Perez on the defense, and he began strolling around the ring for about a good 20 seconds to get away from it.
And that was about one half a second after Rich Morata said Hesta needs to get off first. Now, over in the Perez corner between rounds, what they're asking for as we go to the fifth here in Parker, Arizona, body, body, body shots. Easier said than done. They said they want to forget about the head, get in there, and try to get to Hesta's body. Rich, how are they going to do that?
Well, he even jabbed to the body there. So that's a start. Maybe they want Perez to stay down low. They told him, don't get tall in there. Stay down low.
Ooh, he just walked into a right hand there, Rich. He'll take a lot of punches. We've seen that before.
Well, Hesta is not known. You know, he's not a big one-punch knockout guy. And it takes some work for Hesta to get his. Although in recent fights, it seems to me he's developing more power because his punches have been a little sharper and a little bit cleaner. I've seen him scoring some knockdowns with a good, clean, crisp, quick, precise type shots.
That was good body work there from Hesta, who's turned this thing around after the second round, I would think. He's in love with that lead left. It landed really solid round four, and working for him here. He kind of fakes that right hand out there and pops that left over the top of the right glove of Perez. Perez is just trying to work hard now, getting hit. He just got caught right there inside with a left and a right. But Perez is coming right back toward him.
Yeah, but he stopped punching momentarily, and Hesta made him pay for that. Perez has got to immediately answer back when he gets hit with flurries like that.
Perez's left eye swelling just a little bit there, and it really put the voltage out in his engine. That's what Hesta can do to you, throw those angles and land the hard punches. The wealth of talent. You see Hesta holding those gloves way down like, you can't hurt me. And he knows that by now. He's felt everything Perez is going to bring at him. A nice right hand for Perez, though, Rich.
Yeah, Perez getting his legs back once again. Coming forward.
Another right hand.
That's what Perez needs. He needs to be the guy coming forward.
That got to Hesta. You can see the way he's blinking his eyes. That one got him. Perez keeps charging forward. Like I said, this man, he knows there's another right hand. He has nothing to lose in there, Rich Perez. He said, I might as well bring everything I have.
Hesta trying to be the only top-ranked prospect not to lose tonight. Because Jose Roman won, Andy Ruiz won, Jose Benavidez won, but Hesta's in a real fight here tonight. He is in a real battle.
Perez working real hard as we close out round number five here. It's a matter of will right now as we head to six. We're going to round number six here in Parker, Arizona. Rich, I would like to say after five, how you got it?
I've got halfway point. I've got Perez ahead by a point after through five rounds.
Wow.
And I think this fight is getting better with each succeeding round.
I don't think Hesta expected to be behind on anybody's card after five rounds, but that sounds reasonable to me. Round number six, Hesta is on the right side of the screen. Manny Perez, the veteran on the left side of the screen in the gold trunks. Well, now he's right in front of him. Round number six. And you know, for all the little bit of showboating and the other stuff we saw in round four, I think Hesta better get serious at this point. He's in there against a tough warrior who's going to get the best out of it. And we figured that today when Perez was talking about his training. 9 weeks of preparation, knowing that, you know, everything he's worked for all his life is right in the ring with him tonight.
Well, he sold me in that 10-round draw with Brandon Rios. I mean, and his face was really beat up. It was all puffy. His eyes were closing. And he just still kept coming forward and still was trading with Rios right up to the end of the 10th round.
Whoa. Got to keep him up there. I got a little low there. I was waiting for the referee to step in on that one. I'm telling you, the intensity, you can feel it out here by the Colorado River in this fight, Rich. This is turning out to be quite a matchup. You can just feel it as it builds.
Well, this has been the year of the upset, and Hesta doesn't want to add his name to that list tonight. Just a few weeks ago, we saw another top-ranked prospect lose, Robert Marroquin, who has, of course, gotten a big build-up the last couple of years as he's come up. And And Hessler doesn't want to add his name because there have been a number of big upsets this year in pro boxing.
Closing final minute round number six. No one's really taken charge in this one. This round in particular, a tough round to score so far. We'll see what happens in the final 57.
Hester's doing some good body work in this round. Might pay off for him a little bit later on. It's because Perez is full of energy. Alan, he had such a tremendous training camp.
Yes, he has got it. And he does train at altitude. Lives in Denver, so he's up there in the rare air, and now he's down here at the desert. Seconds left, round number six. Hester missing with that right hand.
Perez turning boxer.
Yes, he's up on his toes. I was going to mention that a little bit earlier. He's starting to box, which nobody expected. Rounds clicking by now. It's a 10-rounder. We're going to complete six. Somebody's got to take charge.
Time!
Round number seven, scheduled for 10, lightweight division. Recito Hesta getting all that he wants from Manny Perez. How'd you go in the sixth round, Rich, on your card? That's a tough one to score.
Yeah, well, with Hesta, I've got the fight dead even, 57 all after six rounds.
So here we go. We're getting down to the gut jack time, going to the final rounds.
I think
round
Hesta,
number seven.
I think Hesta's going to use his jab a little bit more in this round. He's going to start off things with the jab. It could be a good punch to keep Perez off. Although it looks to me like he has a chance to use it here, he's just not doing it.
Perez in the last couple rounds has not been right there in front of him. He's been using more of his footwork and angles. A little body work right there. Now Hester, you know, is finding out what it's like to, when you have to step up in competition to start, you know, earning your reputation. And he's got a guy here tonight that was tailor-made for, you know, making you better. And he's going to have to be better to win this fight.
I don't think Hester's really found a good rhythm here tonight.
I think that's an excellent point, Rich. I just don't think he's not gotten into a point where he knows exactly what kind of attack he's going to bring and let his hands go a little bit. He's kind of short swinging it.
There's that jab.
There it is.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was talking about. Jab, that'll set up his left cross.
Sometimes it takes a little while to figure it out. That certainly looked good. Triple jab, and it came back with a left. There's a right hand again as he got the bat. And it all set up off the jab, Rich. Here he comes. Hester.
Some of the natural ability of Hester is pouring through, and you're seeing it.
There's that rhythm you were talking about, getting into his rhythm to try to take charge of this fight. Left eye of Perez swelling just a little bit right now, and Hester, in the last 20 seconds, the best he's looked all night.
Absolutely, really having a terrific round here. And Perez now can't get started.
And he ate those jabs and set it up with the left, coming across, and Hester's got his confidence up. Blood now coming from the nose of Perez. It's turned into one of those deals for Perez. Hester just loading up now. Sitting down on those punches and saying, here I come. That's almost looking like he wants to close it out in the seventh. Bang, yeah. Body shot.
This is the Hester we've been hearing about, seeing, and what fans have been waiting to see here tonight. He's letting loose.
Letting those hands go and coming from all different angles. The fighter that I saw when I studied him before this fight, and the videos that I saw, this is the kid I was impressed with. Maybe he was patient enough to wait for the right time to do it, Rich. He had a guy well-conditioned in there, was giving him a lot of trouble, and now he's taking charge. Perez landing one right at the end here, trying to fight back, but Hester not hurt. Go to round eight now from Arizona. Interesting turn of events in round number seven. Hester came out and fought like the guy that we heard about, showing what he can do. Perez got swarmed there in that final minute and may have been the turning point in the fight. We'll see what Perez has left. Now, in the Perez corner, they were claiming that Hester was gassed. I don't think so.
I think that was a psychological ploy, but you're right. That's what they're telling. I think Vince Parra was telling Hester the same thing in that corner. Vince Parra, son of boxing vet, Norman Bumpy Parra.
A couple of good work right there for Perez. Just doesn't have enough pop to match up. He's one of those just good enough fighters. Hester trying to work in behind the jab here in round number 8.
Well, you make a good point, Alan. You know, power is a great thing to have, and when you don't have it, you've got to overcome that disadvantage in certain ways. And the way we talked about, even in our keys to victory, was for him to out-hustle and do it with volume punching tonight, his opponent Heston.
Once you pay up, there's some of the volume punching we're talking about. We got that in the first 2 rounds. But there's such a price to pay for that when you get inside all the time, and you got a guy that's a sharpshooter like Heston can be.
Right on the line.
And it seems to me like he should be able to sharpshoot Perez here at this juncture, not only with the lead punches, but
no
with counters.
No shoulders in there, no shoulders.
Perez certainly has a lot of heart, and he's given Hester as much as he can give him tonight. That's all you expect a fighter to do, is give it everything he has, and we've seen that from Perez. Now, as for Hester, he's not exactly following up on what he did the latter part of round number 7 here. He's sort of trying to pick away. I don't think he really has to at this point. I think if he just works behind that jab, like Arana said, and start throwing some punches, he could really slow Perez down to the point he may be able to get him out of there. I don't think he anticipated going the distance with this guy tonight. Trying to walk his way in, watch his footwork, trying to walk his way in, close the distance.
Yeah, but if you're going to walk a man down, you've got a punch when you get in there.
Exactly.
He's doing a lot of posing here, and he never got a punch. He's walking him down.
He's
got a throw.
See how he's moving in, Rich, and not throwing? It's like he's waiting to be countered.
Well, I think he's trying to lure Perez into a mistake. He's holding his right hand down low, hoping that he can counter, make Perez miss, and then counter.
I don't know. Very strange round 8 to me for Hester. Coming off an interesting round 7. Very odd. Final seconds ticking around in round number 8. We're back. Round number 9 in Park, Arizona. Here's some breaking news coming in. I believe Rich Murata has this fight even.
Yeah, I don't think you need to call a press conference about it.
Yeah, but who would have expected after 8 rounds, honestly, Rich, that you'd have it even? I wouldn't be surprised if the judges do, too.
Well, as you said, it was curious the way Hester, in that last round, he just
very
got very hesitant.
Now Perez feeling a little more confident that he may perhaps got left off the hook in round number 8, going out there and working that body, and I'm sure his corners told him, hey, you might be in this thing, so let it go, buddy. You worked this far. You got through 8 rounds. So people may have it even. And if you can just find a way, you might walk out of here with a huge upset tonight. Just 2 rounds to go, even though his corner incorrectly told him after 7 rounds there were 2 rounds to go. I heard that over there. But sometimes they play with the fighter and don't let him know really how much longer they've got to go. 154 ticking down round number 9.
And Perez's face puffing up. Now, the way that it did in that fight with Brandon Rios, especially his left eye. Hester looks to me to be in control of the
ring.
Watch your
head, coming in there, watch your head.
You know, just with ring generalship and dictating here the style of the fight in this round. That was amateurish.
And what's he doing? Yeah, Perez made him pay for it. I mean, what is he doing with that right hand? I mean, he's just telegraphing, come over here, and I'll try to counter with the left. But he needs to pick it up.
Hester getting a little too cute in here, but nonetheless, I think he feels like he's in charge at this point.
Banging away, Perez banging the body. You talk about aggression in your talking points before the show. And that's what you need, that busy fighter. Perez, look at him, banging away to the body. Hester not coming back with anything. Has Hester gotten his mind rich that he can knock him out with one punch? You mentioned he doesn't have that normally type of ability. He has to kind of chop you down. But Perez, let me tell you what, 9 weeks of training, you're seeing it right here, folks. This guy came in here as prepared as he could be to bring as much skill as he can bring to the equation. Hester got him on the end of that punch right there, but Perez has been the aggressor here in round nine, I would think.
I'm just judging Hester's body language, the look on his face and everything, and he seems to me to be a guy who just thinks that he's in charge.
Well, he may not be when the cards come out if this thing goes to D. He looks confident, but he's getting hit.
Time! Touch glove, touch
we are
glove
back.
Right here.
He has gone to round number 10 in this lightweight matchup tonight between Manny Perez in the gold trunks with red trim and Mercito No Mercy Hester in the white trunks with the sort of orange trim. And I don't think anybody expected it, but I think Perez in his corner certainly respected it. I was eavesdropping, Rich, as I sometimes do in the Perez corner. They were telling him to go out and let it all out and go for a knockout, which I don't know. Now Hester stepping it up here, taking charge, and showing the aggression we haven't seen since round number 7.
Right, he comes out here immediately to take command.
They're going to war, Rich, in this round. Here we go.
Well, I know this about Perez. He's not going to back down.
Now Hester on the ropes right there. Well, more or less Hester chose to be and steps around. 2 minutes left in this fight.
Hester got off to a big start in this round, first 30 seconds. That's not enough to carry him to victory in the round yet.
Blood dripping down the nose of Perez, which is not unusual. He usually gets banged up pretty good around the face. I think Rich has made a good point throughout most of this fight. Hester has acted like a fighter who has assumed that he is pitching a shutout, and he's really not.
Well, we've had a number of close rounds. I would say about 6 or 7 of the rounds you could make a case for either fighter, actually, Alan. And you have that. You sometimes have wildly divergent scorecards. And much of it depends on how a judge likes to see a fighter fight, whether he counts a lot toward aggression or whether he counts a lot for a ring generalship.
109 left in this fight here at the Blue Water Resort and Casino, the amphitheater here in Parker, Arizona, right by the beautiful Colorado River. And this has been quite a matchup in our featured bout tonight. 54 seconds left. Perez, not as much talent, but certainly equal in heart. Laying it all out there tonight, as he said he would, against the favored fighter, Hester, the Filipino, who came in with some sensational performances coming in, but he's just faced a worker tonight.
I tell you, he's a grinder. Manny is a gamer. There's no doubt about that. And Hester, I think, is having a big 10th round.
And Manny's saying, bring it on. 26 seconds left. Here's a guy who knows his whole boxing future could turn. Hester's got that sarcastic grin on his face. And Perez may be scoring some points here. I don't know if sarcasm's going to get it done at this point as he walks away in the final seconds of this fight. Hester's going backwards, Rich. We may have an interesting judge situation on our hands here. Don't you think?
Oh, absolutely.
Going to be interesting. Perez puts his hand in the air to say, and his corner picks him up to say, look what I did. I gave everything I had. I did what I wanted to do tonight. Pitching Hester to the distance. I don't know if they're all that pleased over the Hester corner, to tell you the truth.
That was a tough fight. And I think you have two corners here, both of which think they won the fight.
That's what I'm talking about.
Well, we're anxiously awaiting what the judges here in Arizona come up with. So don't go away. We'll be back with that on Top Rank Live in just a few. Well, it went the distance in our featured bout tonight. Everybody anxiously awaiting Lupe Contreras to give us the decision. And I don't have a clue, but we'll find out when we get to him.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds of action, the scorecard reads as follows. Damas y caballeros, después de 10 vueltas, esta es la decisión oficial. Judges Flores and Wilson scored about identically at 98 to 92. Los jueces Flores y Wilson entregan tarjetas idénticas de 98 a 92. El juez Valenzuela anotó 99-91. Judge Valenzuela scores it 99-91. For the winner, by way of unanimous decision. Para el ganador, por decisión unánime. Mercito.
Does very well is that he can throw from all angles. He's got a very big repertoire of punches that can hurt you. Uppercuts, hooks, body punches. Right there going downstairs.
Right. Well, he's left-handed to start with, so that's the first similarity to Manny. And he will give you angles and some different looks, but not the crazy angles that Pacquiao gives you. I mean, we've actually seen Pacquiao on a number of occasions, and it really,
mind-boggling.
All kidding aside, he winds up behind his opponents, you know. Yeah. So, I haven't seen that yet with Hesta. And Hesta trying to give some different looks here to Perez. He's going to be ready, I think, for just about anything tonight.
Yeah, he's in the white trunks with the, I guess it's kind of an orange trim.
One bout even, and 12 of his victories coming by way of knockout. Invicto hasta el momento a nivel profesional, con 22 victorias, un empate, y 12 de sus victorias por la vía del knockout. Representing Lobogon, the Philippines, Mercito, No Mercy Hesta.
Chief second. 1 second, over. Okay, gentlemen, went over the rules in the dressing room. Check these trunks, these are good. From here, it's gonna be low. Check these
tres de sus victorias por la vía del knockout, he enters the ring with 16 professional victories against 6 losses, 1 bout even, and 3 of his victories coming by way of knockout. Fighting out of Denver, Colorado, Manny Manos Pérez. His opponent across the ring in the red corner, su contrario en la esquina roja. Vestido de plateado con color naranja, he steps in wearing silver trimmed in orange. He weighed in at an identical 136 pounds. Detuvo la báscula a un peso idéntico de 136 libras. He enters the ring, an undefeated fighter with 22 victories. This song, the judges are Chris Flores, Gustavo Valenzuela, and Chris Wilson. The referee, Wes Melton. And now, ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, from Parker, Arizona, veremos quién es el más macho. Introducing the blue corner, presentando la esquina azul, vestido de dorado con vivos rojos. He steps in wearing gold trimmed in red. He weighed in officially at 136 pounds. Detuvo la báscula a un peso oficial de 136 libras. Con 16 victorias profesionales, 6 derrotas, un empate.
Trunks, these are good. I'm going to call them low from here. I want you to have a good, clean fight. Protect yourself at all times. Obey my commands. Let's touch him up and bang at the bell.
And it looks as though Manny Perez's nose is marked up already.
Yep, but it got busted up. And that second fight against Brandon Rios. He's had some tough sparring sessions, talked about how hard he's been working for this fight. Said he couldn't be more prepared. He's had 9 weeks to get ready for Hesta. Will it be enough? We'll have to see. Hesta, you know, he talked about at the top of the telecast about trying to live up, and he's not really trying to, but you know, everything's compared to Pacquiao and Donaire. There's some things I see, Rich, that...